G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week we are going to create the fake window effect. We're going to do two different looks. We've got our color look here with our model looking like she's behind the window with the reflections of New York City. And also we're going to create this little gritty street photo look as well, also with the fake window effect. But as usual, let's get started. We're going to start off with the picture of our model here, and we're going to add the picture of our city. So we're going to come over here to grab this picture of New York City. I'm simply going to go Command C and come over to the picture of our model and Command V. I'm going to use my move tool now just to position that photo. I'm going to use my Command minus just to make that a little bit smaller and just position our photo of New York City here. I'm going to move it over a little bit, and that looks pretty good. But on our background here, we're going to make sure we're on our move tool, and we're going to come up here to arrange and flip horizontally. So when you look in a mirror, you always see the words of the reflection horizontally flipped around the other way. So that's what we're going to do here as well. So we flip that horizontally. Also on our background of the city here, we're going to add a Gaussian blur, and I'm going to take that up to about 15 to just blur that background. With the photo, you wouldn't see the background really sharp in the reflection, so we're going to add a little bit of Gaussian blur on that background. Okay, the next thing we're going to do on our background is change our blend mode here. I'm going to change our blend mode to screen, and I'm also at this stage going to just drop that down to about 70%. And now it gives us the opportunity just to move that background into a better location, and I'm going to move it to about here. Looks pretty good. The other thing I'm going to do is just on this background, I'm going to add a mask, and on the mask layer, I'm going to grab my gradient tool. I'm just going to put a small gradient down here. I'm going to make sure that this bottom gradient here is on black, and now I'm just going to manipulate it a little bit so we don't see the reflection sort of down here on the table here. So I'm just going to put that reflection about here, because you wouldn't see sort of the reflection in the table here, just above the table on the model. So quite happy with that at the moment. On my model layer here, I'm just going to add a levels adjustment and clip that just to my model here. And on the output white, I'm just going to bring down the intensity of the highlights, and I'm just going to bring that down to about 85. Okay, let's have a look at that. That looks pretty good. The next thing I'm going to do for our fake window effect is add a new pixel layer right on the top here. This is going to look a little bit strange to start off with, but bear with me. I'm going to grab my brush tool, make sure I'm painting in white, grab a fairly soft brush, make sure that's still in white, and make my brush quite big, my right and left bracket keys. I'm just going to click once up the top here, hold my shift key and click down here, and do this down this side as well. And to make my brush a little bit bigger, do the same, click once, hold your shift key and then click down the bottom. Do this a few times. Let's make the brush a little bit bigger and go right from that corner to that corner. Click once, hold down shift, click again. Make my brush a little bit smaller, all different size brushes here. Click once, click down, click once, click down. Let's do a few of these all the way across. This is going to look really strange, I know. I have done this in another video before to get the same sort of effect. So let's grab that brush again, quite big now, straight down there, and put all these sort of lines right across. That looks pretty good. So we've got all these white lines going down. Okay, on that layer there, that pixel layer that we've just done all these strange white brush strokes, let's add a Gaussian blur. And let's take that Gaussian blur all the way up to 100. And then let's drop that effect on that layer by 45%. Looks pretty good. Okay, let's have a look. That looks pretty good. Okay, the last thing, or one of the last things we're going to do, we might just add a curves to finish off. Flatten those blacks a little bit. Let's grab our S curve, very slight S curve. Bring that a little bit darker. Okay, that looks pretty good. There's our color fake window effect in Affinity Photo. Let's see where we started. We started from here, and we've added that fake window effect over the top of that picture, looking pretty good with our reflections in the background. So let's add a black and white adjustment layer. So let's come up here to adjustments, And on my black and white adjustment layers here, I've actually got the actual black and white, this one here, that's a preset, which I'm going to click that. And for anyone that hasn't watched Affinity Revolution's latest video, it's really well worth a watch. And I'm using the settings that they suggested in that video. I'll put the video here and I'll put a link down below. If you haven't watched that video, go and take a look. It is a really great video talking about the settings for black and white. Okay, so these are my settings here from that video and from that preset. And I think it makes a really nice black and white photo. And the last thing I'm going to do on this photo is come down here to my live filters. I'm going to add noise. So I'm going to come down to add noise. We want that noise just by itself right on top, all the way on top here, add noise. And I'm going to turn that up to about 15% and hit enter. And it makes that sort of like a gritty street photo, sort of black and white gritty street photo. So there you go, everybody. We started with the photo of our model here. We've added the street in the background. We've added our brush strokes to give it that fake window effect, making it come alive a little bit more. We've added a curves adjustment. We've added our black and white adjustment. And we've also added a little bit of noise to give it that sort of gritty street photo look. So we've got our colored photo and we've got our black and white photo. So if you have enjoyed the tutorial this week, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe. I'll see you in my next video.